He never kept a diary or wrote an autobiography throughout his life. There are only a few traces left about his life. And this residence is evidence to that. Let's take a glimpse into the ideological universe of Tom H. Fong, a giant of contemporary philosophy.
方东美教授呢，算是对于台湾大学啊哲学系的主要的一个创始人啊，而且对台湾的哲学方面的一个思想以及影响非常大。
方东美在哲学与文化的或教育上啊，他的成就是蛮多的啦。但最重要当然是他希望建构未来的世界哲学。那这一部分的哲学蓝图，其实跟他在台大教的人生哲学最有关系。
Tom H. Fong was born in Tongcheng, Anhui, in 1899. Born in a scholarly family.He started reading the classics of poetry at the age of three, having a profound foundation in Confucianism. At the age of 18, Tom was admitted to Jinling University and then entered the Department of Liberal Arts and Philosophy. While in school, he participated in the May 4th movement in Nanjing. He was also one of the crucial members of the Young China Society at that time.At the age of 22, Tom went to the United States to study philosophy at University of Wisconsin, obtaining a master's degree in 2 years. Tom was passionate about studying the idealism of Hegel. After returning to the country, he remained devoted to the world of philosophy.
方东美的教授的故居，我们是在那个孤岭街。的六十巷四号跟六号，四号是那个方东美教授的故居，六号是那个刘南敏教授的故居，应该是当初呢日治时代的帝国大学的教授的宿舍群。
Tom H. Fong is known as the Asian poet and philosopher in the history of modern philosophy and thought, advocating the Tongcheng School of Literary Prose.Which is writing for the purpose of promoting doctrines. As the 16th generation descendant of founder Fong Bao, Tom H. Fong not only promoted Chinese culture throughout his life, but also integrated himself with Western culture. In his later years, he established the New Confucian system, which was later praised as the philosophical origin of New Confucianism.And earned a high reputation internationally.
因为建在台湾大学是当时日本在统治时期在台湾设立的一个这个大学，在当时呢就设立了很多给这些教授啊或是这些行政人员住宿的地方，他们就在这里盖了很多日式的宿舍啊，来作为这些教授跟行政人员的。住宿的空间，是这个地点的因素是这样子的来的。
Tom H. Fong residence was built in 1929. In the middle of the Japanese rule period, it was affiliated to Guting Village, Taipei City, which later became affiliated to Sakumacho, following the changes of town names. Due to its proximity to the Taipei City walls,The buildings in Sakumacho were designated complexes for use by government agencies and their official residences. After World War II, Taipei experienced rapid development under urban planning. Roads were being widened, and many new plans have been added, progressively changing the landscape during the Japanese colonial period. However,A large number of Japanese-style dormitories in this area remained. In addition to residential buildings, many public departments and medical facilities have also been preserved, becoming a feature of this area. In 1947, Tom H. Fong visited Taiwan for a lecture and then relocated to Taiwan ever since. In the following year, he accepted the offer of Zhuang Chongkong, the then president of National Taiwan University, and started teaching at the Department of Philosophy, National Taiwan University. During this period, he stayed in the NTU dormitory complex on Guling Street.
因为他提供住宿的是比较属于像高层的人去住宿的，所以他有独立的建筑，有自己的庭园，还有前后院，所以说这个是可以看出当时对于这种比较高级的，不管是官员或是知识分子呢的一种待遇的。
那个建筑哈，我第一次来是陪邦老师呢，搭辅大校车到西门町下车，啊，那是我第一次进来，啊，那当然就开始聊天啦，聊很多东西啊，那一直聊到两点多，方师母才出来说，啊，赶快来吃饭。我就在边吃，那是我第一个印象。那时候我来的时候也是看，哇，这个房子还不错哈。
Tom H. Fong has been teaching for more than 50 years, and his distinguished students include former Premier of Executive Yuan Li Huan, late President Jiang Qingguo, and most venerable Qin Keng, to name a few. They have sought after the wisdom of Tom. His students can be found everywhere. He not only made outstanding contributions to philosophy with his thoughts,but also profoundly influences his students with his lecturing attitude.
我曾经听过那个詹天权詹教授，他讲过，他说他以前他年轻的时候去台大上课哈，是主要是上黄东美教授的课。他说那个教室里面大概只能坐五十几个人的教室，结果挤满了250个人。他是爬在窗户上面，手拉着那个窗框，这样在听课。所以当初你看，所以就知道说那个黄东美教授他在人生哲学的部分跟佛学他都是一个占有很大的重要地位。
第一次听黄东美演讲是在更新文教院，他公开的演讲，他很少公开演讲。在辅仁大学上课那第一天，我真的很压抑，那个讲台很大，全部摆了录音机，很多学生都拿录音机去录，我第一次看到还有上课要录音的。啊，第二个印象比较压抑，说怎么来上课有一些年纪好大的人。后来才知道，除了哲学系的学生、研究生以外，有很多是大学的老师在上课，已经在大学教书的人在那边旁听了。更意外的是，我是自己从老远跑去旁听，对不对？但是跟我旁听的居然还有比我更远的，因为每一个学生接触老师的年龄都不同，大概啦啊，一般他年长学生的讲法是望之俨然，及之也温，这看起来很严肃，可是你跟他一接触就觉得很温和。他们哦，夫妻哦，买书哦，方先生都他们都叫做做坏事了，以前那个年代都是讲西方料然后再定做了，结果他从外面回来就抱了好像是西装料就溜回他的书房，闷不作声，但是又好像很高兴。然后方师母就说，哎，那西装料拿过来我们去做啊哈，结果他不开门，因为这种日式的门他就把他拉住不让他开。那方师母就觉得说，你再不开的话，不过方师母已经料到可能是妈去买书了，所以方师母说，你再不开我就不理你了。那一开，果然是买了一大堆书。
Tom H. Fong taught at National Taiwan University for 25 years.After retirement, he taught as a visiting lecturer at Fujian Catholic University for 2 years. During his tenure, he had sudden discomfort and decided to resign to rest at home. After discussion with the physician, upon aggravation of illness in the following year.
比较印象深刻是最后一次， 啊，那一天我跟傅佩荣来这边，那时候已经生病了哈，生病的后期，突然间病情状况加剧，啊，那时候就打就叫119，那我跟傅佩荣就上救护车，啊，就直接送到邮政医院去，那是最后一次。
他其实因为方教授离开了之后呢，就没有人住了哈。其实房子都一样，当你没有人在里面居住的时候，他就没有做好维护的情况之下，哈，就很容易就会破败。
我想很多事情都是随缘而来的，因为当初我们那个建设公司，我们标了这块土地在后面。那后来我想在盖的过程中我来看的时候才发现说，哎，后面怎么有一块基地哈，那房子几乎全部倒塌，变成一堆木头在上面杂草丛生。我就请同事去问问看说这个房子到底是谁的，啊，后来才知道说原来是台大的。其实我本来其实我不认识方多美教授，啊，他讲到说方多美教授他是那个台大很有名的那个哲学系教授，而且是研究华严经很深入，我觉得一个方多美教授这么一个重要的人物，怎么可以把他的房子败坏在这边没有修复啊？就因为这样子，才有这样的起因，我来修复了，方多美教授的故居。
首先呢，啊，就必须要去把它整个构建做一个厘清，甚至去重新绘制图面，啊，去做修复的一个动作，啊，那另外呢，就是它的这个建材本身呢，啊，我们都尽量沿用，能够留用的我们就留用，像一些瓦片等等，这个木料如果说它还是维持原来的状况，我们就尽量沿用。那如果说真的坏掉了，或是要抽换的，或是要检修的，再透过这样的一个程序去做这样的一个设计，当然包含了它的原貌怎么去让它尽量回到它当时原来的状况，所以它其实是有以前都有日式的施工图的。所以说我们等于是每一根构件，每一根这个墙体，每一根这个瓦片，就都是重新检视过，透过修复过程去复原做，但是它的软体的部分，也就是它的历史部分，你不可能去改变它的啊，那这个东西确实就是它最有价值的部分。
那既然它是一个日式的房子，我们希望说能修旧如旧。那因为当初主要是都是教授们住的或校长住的，所以庭园景观上他们比较没有做得像很重要的观设，所以后来我们再加强，把那个旁边的那个空地，我们做了一个枯山水，还有做了一个新字词，哦，就比较再更符合那个日式房子跟它的那个庭园景观，我想这个是很值得把它保存下来，让下一代的人可以欣赏跟使用。
Tom H. Fong passed away in 1977. With tearful condolences of family members, relatives, friends, and representatives from everywhere, a simple and solemn burial at sea was held in Lialuo Bay, Kinmen.At that time, Mr. Jiang Jingguo, the then Premier of Executive Yuan of Taiwan, was also present at the service. To express his infinite condolences and admiration to this scholar whose students are from all over the world. After his decease, the widowed wife of Tom H. Fong donated his collection of books owned by him during his lifetime and continued to live in the dormitory complex.Until she died in 1991. The life story of the two people in this residence spanned nearly half a century and concluded with Mrs. Fong's death.
那我想这个房子我是希望说，因为它是方多美教授的故居，因为它是谈人生哲学，谈哲学还有佛学的部分，所以我那时候就在想说，将来我如果修复完成，我也是希望说能有老师可以来这边讲人生哲学，还有讲经。
In collaboration with Taiwanese and international artists, the Tom H. Fong residence becomes a platform to display creators' silverware, ceramics, and fine craftsmanship works. Furthermore, guided tours, tea ceremony courses, etc. will occasionally be held here and from time to time. The surroundings, ambiances, and essential urban characters are preserved by reactivating the connections within the area through exchanges. In combination with food and beverage space applications at number 6 Guling Street.
我想你们也访问过郭董嘛，哈，那他其实这一栋建筑物最主要是郭董当时花了很多心力跟精神，好，把它留下来。我想如果说以后不是只是来看啊老房子，而是说曾经有日本人在住过，而且又有一个很重要的人物在那边住过，那他的生活的模式、他的论述、他的研究、他的这个思想，我想可以在这边做一个发扬。
这段话是很有名的，因为这是在世界哲学家会议受访的时候讲的话。他说，我的家学渊源是儒家哲学，受的思想方法训练是西方哲学，中心欣赏的生命情调是道家哲学，向往心仪的是大乘佛学。其实这段话可以看出他的人生生活形式，
因为个人喜欢历史建筑也喜欢，那我觉得做说修复这样是蛮有意义的，把这些建筑物把它保存下来，那我们再利用，让更多人来享用，让下一代的人都还可以来了解这个历史建筑物这样子。
他认为啊，念哲学第一步就是第一堂课应该是去搭飞机。方东美是觉得很多华严经所描绘的世界，很多在飞机上会好像一个相应的感觉，但是最重要还是整体的问题的，你俯视俯瞰世界是整体的，要不然你永远搞不清楚整个世界。
At the candlelight farewell party where Tom H. Fong took his leave from lecturing in 1972, he left word. This great scholar and instructor who had worked hard for 50 years passed on his knowledge to countless students, so that his spirit became perpetual.